All right, I'm just about done cleaning her up. Got the sump cleaned out. Got all the handles polished, and then just gave her a good wipe down. I got the plates, the badges all grinded down so that you could see what you're doing. And I think I'm gonna go ahead and go one step further. I got this plate here that's looks like it's original material. It's pretty beat up though, really thin stuff. I mean, this is probably like 14 gauge stuff, real thin and just all beat up. And before I go and assemble this all these electrical components and close it up, I figured I might as well just go ahead and do it now if I'm going to take it all apart. You can see how bent it is. And if you look underneath, it's supported by some quarter inch plate or quarter inch flat bar. So I'm going to dig around and see what I have that could fit this. So it's 24 by 13 and it's a little bit short. If you look at the top, I'll bring you in to look at the top of this. I think they're really missing the opportunity to give you some more room here. So 24 inches by 13 inches, and you got all this in the back that they just kind of missed out. And then you have your cap here. So they're clearing this cap, but then they just miss everything else out over here. So I'm gonna see if I can't do a little bit better. Okay, I think I may have lucked out. I found this quarter inch piece of plate in my file. It's already cut. And let's see what we got. We got 18 and a half inches by 24 inches. So it gives us a little bit extra room and quarter inch plate, not this thin stuff here. So I think this might work. We'll get this one taken off and we'll see how it fits. We are on day two of the build, and I got the machine cleaned up. I got the old plate taken off and cleaned up the top end, and I grounded these plates a little bit more so that you could see the details that are on them. So now this is my area I have to work with. Let's go ahead and set the plate on here and see how it fits. We'll take this cap off just so that we don't damage it. That is almost a perfect fit. The other plate extended out about like this. And I didn't care for it too much because it feels like it's in the way. And whenever you're messing with the handles and trying to adjust the speed, it really gets in your way. On this end, it sticks out a little bit. So what we're gonna have to do is recess a notch right in here. And let me show you, let me bring you in closer so you can see what I'm talking about.
So you can see these handles right here. And the other plate stuck out about this far. I think what I'm going to do is push this back as far as I can, so just like this, and really open up this space right here. Then you can see on this side we're getting a little close to getting to the back of the chuck. So I think I want to recess this just so that it sets back just even with this wall here. And that's only about maybe an inch or 3/4 of an inch. This needs to go back. Then I will have to cut a hole so that we can access the oil port. Then I'll have to put a rim around the whole thing. But otherwise, this piece of plate looks like it was made for this. So let's go ahead and get going. So I do have a little bit of a problem. These are the bolts that come with the plate and these spacers. And so this spacer sits underneath the plate and then the bolt goes through it. And that plate was only held on by two bolts. So there's only two fastening bolts to hold that whole plate on. But the plate that I'm using is a lot heavier and I don't only want to support it from one end. So I'm gonna have to figure out a way to support it from these two bolts on the back side as well. And I just need to make sure that they're all the same bolts. So I'm gonna take these out and make sure that they're the same thread and thickness and everything. So you can see that these bolts are thinner or shorter, but I believe they're the same thread size. Yep, they are. So I'll be tapping into these two holes here and then these two up front.
All these bitches is my sons, and I'ma go and get some bibs for them. A couple formulas, little pretty lids on them. If I had a dip, I would pull it out and sit on them. Let me shake it off. I just signed a couple deals, I might break you off. And we ain't making up, I don't need a mediator. Just let them bums blow steam, radiator.
That was an earthquake, man.
This stone is flawless. F1, I keep shooters up top in the F1. A lot of bad bitches begging me to F1, but I'ma eat them rat bitches when the chef come. Throw some fresh ones. More talent than my motherfucking left thumb. She ain't a Nicki fan, then the bitch deaf dumb. You ain't my son, you my motherfucking stepson.
I don't know what
that
way look like.
I can't
even
explain.
You got me.
Put your number twos in the air if you're bending on them.
We at the top, bitch. The G5. Louis Vuitton, everything. Gucci, we don't fuck with it.
All these bitches is my sons, and I ain't talking about Phoenix. Bitch, I get money so I do's what I pleases. I live with the motherfucking pools and the trees is. Broke bitch is so crusty, disgust me. Day the bitch arrive, got the continental dusty. Trust me, I keep a couple hundred in the duffy. Couple wet wipes, case a bum try to touch me. Ew. I'm the Terminator. Rich talk slick, I'ma have to Terminator. These little nappy headed hoes need a Permanator. You my seed, I spray you with the Germinator. Move back bugs. Matter of fact, you know the queen could use a back rub. If you could turn back time, chair. You used to be here, now you're gone, near.
You nappy headed son of a bitch. I'ma start throwing shots from me, bro. At your head. I'ma get the kid version.